Hello everyone, this is the Wakfu Guide, and today I'm gonna give a little tutorial about the interface of Wakfu. By watching this video, I assume you've never played Wakfu yet or just getting started, and this is just to help out where to find certain things that you're looking for and that you need during your game. So without further ado, let's get started. The first thing I want to talk about is the shop. If you don't want to spend any money on this game, that's perfectly fine. This is just pure costumes and sidekicks, which are companions in battle, or boosters, or decorations, stuff like that. Most of them don't have any additional effect. Some do, but it's completely optional. In the description are links to other parts of this same video. If you want to look for a certain thing, you can skip by clicking one of those links in the description. So yeah, you can just buy certain stuff here, and you need origins for that, which you can also buy here or from the official site wakfu.com/english en, or if you have another language, it has another end, but just wakfu.com is fine. And you also have cross tokens, which are from a different game. I'm not going to talk about it now, it has nothing to do with this. Second one are the gifts. When Wakfu has distributions or special events going on, or some error and everybody gets compensated, you can find those here. Some are with a code, wakfu.com/english/codes. You can fill in the code if you get a code somewhere. If you just started, you don't have this at all. It doesn't pop up, it just says shop. So don't worry about it if it's not there. Second or third thing are the stats, the additional stat boosters. This one, for example, this one is a timed one, Almanac's Blessing. You can get one each day at the Temple of Almanacs. And you also get the Almoken, which you can buy stuff with. Today's one, or yesterday's, today's one is Crafting XP and Crafting Speed. I have it for another hour and 13 minutes. And you have things like guild bonuses, and this one, Crafty Elf, is for my costume. It gets extra spells during Christmas. There's a special Christmas place, Christmas World. I'm not gonna go further into that, because otherwise this video will be very long. Then you have the chat bar here. You can use this for chat. By default, journal is just marked with game log, and general is everything else. I made it different. You can click on these to disable certain things in the chat, and you can add a few others like this. Like, you can just say something right here, it will pop up. You can have four maximum. There's several. One of them, vicinity, is general, so everything everything general will be white. Private is when someone sends you a private message, so only you can read that. A game log is just what the game tells you, which I have on here. Like, I use some transmutations, and I had a battle, so it says XP get from this spell and stuff like that. Then you have the group. When you're in a group of players or sidekicks, like I'm over here, this is where you find all the group members. You can say something in the group, like Wu has a key to the dungeon, and everybody in the group can read that. But of course, it's our my sidekick, so only I'm the one reading it. But it's just an example. By clicking on these, you can determine where you want to send something. However, for private, I don't recommend doing it like this. If you have someone in the contact list or something, or in the guild, like this guy, Heartpiecer, to start private chat and just type something in here and press enter. I'm not going to do that right now because I don't want to bother them. I will get into guild later. Then you have the guild chat, of course, which will say something in the guild. Every guild member can read that. Trade. Usually, when you want to trade something, you start with want to trade or want to sell, and then the items you want to trade or sell. And then you have politics, that isn't really interesting if you're not into that. It's not politics won't really affect the game if you're not involved in the government of a nation itself. Team, I never use this, no one does. Team is basically the same as group, but you can't make a team, it's just a group. And recruitment is like you're when looking for a dungeon, so looking for a group, LFG, Cobalt dungeon or something, and then one of six, because you still need five more members, or three if you have sidekicks. Even though I would completely dominate the dungeon by myself at this level, even if I didn't try anything hard. So that's it for the chat. I'm gonna put this back to guild. Then you have this bottom bar over here. These are shortcuts, I will get into that later. First up is characteristics. The shortcut is the P button. This will show characteristics also of your sidekicks if you have them over here. Basically your base stats, stuff like that. I will make a separate video on what every stat exactly does and how it affects the game. And this will show you your class, your name, your level, your nation. If you're still starting, this will be blank. And the XP you need for current for the next level, I just leveled up, so I still need a lot to reach level 160. The spells, shortcut is S. This will show you all the spells. You can click on them and then read information about them and equip them and make three separate decks. I will get into that in another video as well. And passives, which are basically abilities, additional skills that are always active. The next one, inventory, shortcut is I. This will show all the items you have and what you have equipped, also of the sidekicks. These don't have many equipped right now. But here you can manage all your items and use them. Like if you also see your inventory and you're still low level, you're probably wondering how does he have so many slots, because when you're just starting out you only have like 30 or 40 slots, I believe. I don't know what's the default, but it's pretty low. And you can have these bags which you can increase it with. You can buy these off a market or make them with the handyman profession, but I recommend buying them. This one is very easy to get. You need to be level 55 and do the Dark Hurl dungeon on Calamar Island with 6 players and need to be cursed, which doesn't really do much. It just halves your attack points. And when you complete it, you get this bag. It's 30 is the max, so 29 is really good for a free bag, which is easy to get. Also, when you have something like here and you want to have it on a shortcut, like let's see, you have bread or healing items. Let's see, I don't have for most bread. This one just gives an effect, like fatality gives me more health for 15 minutes. But you see, I just used it and it's now gone. I have to click on it again. And with normal bread, you have like a heart, which makes them use just as much till you gain full HP. But that's only for subscribers. So what you can do is put it in a shortcut and just press that shortcut numerous times. That's way faster. And just drag it out of there if you want to remove it like this. So that's for the shortcuts. You can have 4 maximum, and you can click on the numbers here to make them appear and just put them on the side of your screen. Oh, someone went online on my Steam. I have it linked to Steam. I have an original account, of course. It came out on Steam way later. I have it since I was a member since open beta, but I take big breaks. I only use 2 because I don't need that much. So next up is the professions. Shortcut is J, or you can click once again, click here. This will show you all your current professions and what you can make with it. Crafting professions are just for crafting, and then you have the gathering professions. You need to gather items over in this place. There isn't really much, but like mobs require that. Like I need to be trapper level 90 to harvest mechanical essence from this guy. but I'm just level 50, so I won't be able to. And you don't have this with the crafting professions, like you see this is just a hammer, but with the gathering professions you can switch between these, so you you can see what you can craft for the profession, or where at what level you can harvest certain things. And when you if you want to know more about fashion, you can click this profession book. By default you don't know any of the professions yet. I will make a separate video on the professions, but you need to go to I recommend going to an outpost and nation outpost and talk to every guy at the beginning, and they will teach you all of these professions except Gamma Mint. You can have this from the start, but it isn't really special. So that's it for the professions. Then you have the sidekicks. Like you see, I already had these two equipped. You can kick them out of the group by pressing the minus button, or let them join again by clicking on their icon. You also have heroes, which are basically characters from the same account, but different characters. I can't equip these right now because I don't have heroes, so you need to buy those. But it's really handy. You can also just have two Wakfu games running at the same time. So I have like two monitors, so I can run one on this monitor and one on the other, and just have two separate accounts. That works as well, but this is way more convenient, believe me. If you have the money and you're not afraid to spend it, I recommend doing this. You have like 20 euros for 2 months plus two heroes, or one hero is cheaper if you only want one. You can have maximum of two. These are just two, but there will be more characters if you have more characters on your account. This is just coincidence. And here you can also see a bit more about the sidekicks. Oh yeah, one more thing. The more sidekicks you have and the higher levels they are, you will reach ranks, and those will give you rewards, which you do need to buy, but it's all very, very cheap. And the last one I can buy is title of approval of requires rank 6. And when I reach rank 7, I will be able to buy this emote pack rally. And at level 8, I will be able to buy these bow wolves, whatever you want to call them. But these are mounts and they're very, very good. So that's it for the sidekicks. Then you have the community. Some of these are important, some of these are not. You have team search, shift P. This will be default damage. You can say like, oh, I'm specialized in a tank or something, or a positioner or something like that. And you can search for people. No one uses this, so it's not really worth looking into. Don't fuss about it. No one looks at this. You have your passport. You will probably be introduced to this short in the game about level 15 or something. You'll get a passport, and you have to choose a nation. I have a separate video on that. I will make a link in the description about choosing a nation, because it's very, very early on in the game. It is one of my older videos. I'm not sure if I used the microphone there, because in my earlier videos I used the in-game chat to communicate. So that's one thing. And if you earn a title, which are mostly from achievements, but also from some quests, they will be displayed here, and you can click on them. I have now unbeatable title, and when someone hovers over your character, you see like Koen HS, and then unbeatable, that's your title, and Sacred Light, that's my guild. I get later into the guild. Your nation, of course, you can change these nations once a month if you reach level 30. So it will remove your outlaw status if you have those, which brings me to citizenship points. Doing positive things, like when the area is overpopulated and you kill some mobs, you will gain citizens points. But when there are not enough mobs and you keep killing them, you will gain negative. When you reach minus 100, you get like 10 for every action. When you reach minus 100, you will be an outlaw, and if people attack you and they have a guard insignia, which means they are guard of that nation, you will be sent to jail and you won't be able to get out until a certain period of time. I was once in there for 13 hours, so beware of that. And this your status, 0 is resident, minus 100 is outlaw, 100 is, I don't know, they all have separate names. About every, it says right here, like 10 CP you get nation bonuses, 100 CP you can vote, and 1000 you can stand for an election as governor, which means you're the boss of a nation for a certain amount of time. It's not like you can do everything and gain access to everything or something like that, or set certain rules like, oh, you have to pay if you want to get through here. It's not that corrupt. And the bonuses for the certain area, it will also say here, so you don't have to look at that each time. And PvP, this you can activate this at level 35 and onward. I will probably make a separate video about this, but I'm not sure yet. And over here you see the secrets. These are the artifacts, and these are all linked to quests. I think you already have the traverse compass. It will have a green check mark. You can pass fog, and yeah, you get more and more the higher you get. And they allow you to access certain places which have treasures, like you see. I don't have 171 yet because I'm 159. Like I said, I know a whole lot about the game, but I take big breaks, so my level isn't maxed out yet. Maximum level cap at the recording time of this video is 200. So yeah, the next thing, the contact list. Shortcut to C when you have a friend. You can also do it here, like Boss Eater. Right click. They have to talk to you. You can't say talk to Boss Eater and then right click, but it will say add to my friends. If I click that, it will now be added to my friends, and it will show their level if they're online. Their account name and their current character name. And you can say things about this player, or ask them if the group of want to start a chat, stuff like that, and just remove it by clicking the cross. These are all my friends, but they're offline. And also the ignore list. These I use for the kind of people that are farm bots. I don't get all those messages like game9.com of whatever it was, something like that. By commas now, it's all third party. I'm against that. So you get like this entire chat box will be filled up if you don't add them to your ignore list. The same way. Right click, add to ignore list. I'm not gonna do that because he's a guildmate of mine. So yeah, the next thing, the guild. If you're not in a guild, this won't work and this won't pop up. But the short key is G. This will show who in the guild is online, what their guild points are, which you need to make upgrades. But the maximum level is 10, and my guild already has all the upgrades, so we have a lot of guild points. The members, if you want to invite someone and you have those rights, you need to have those rights. You have all kinds of ranks which people can give to you. Improvements, like what do they have at level 5? Oh, they have this stuff. Let me see. They already have all of them, but this will list all the bonuses. And the Haven World, if your guild has one, this is expensive as fuck. If your guild has about 140 million commas, you can afford something like this. Otherwise, and that's just the Haven World. It's basically a haven bag, but for an entire guild, and they're limited. That's why they're so expensive. But I'm in one of the biggest guilds in the game, so my guild has one, and it gives all these bonuses. So yeah, it's quite a lot. I will leave it here if you want to see. So one more thing is the politics. If you're not into this, once again, it's not. It won't affect you a lot. This will just say who the governor is of the nation that you are in. I'm in Brockmar, so I can only see the governor of Brockmar. You can see the other governors somewhere else if you go to a nation board. But that's not what this video is about. The guild he's in, he's the same guild as mine. His Wakfu and Stasis. I will get into that later, but it's not really important. If you want to be a governor, you do want to have maximum Wakfu. Otherwise, there's not much chance you get voted on, unless you have the entire guild behind your back, and they're all subscribed so they can vote, because you need subscription to vote. And some other things about the nation, not really important right now. You can look in that when you want to look at politics and stuff like that. Then we have the quest management. First one's almanacs. No one looks at this. It's just a calendar. Not really special. So I'm not going to go into that. It doesn't even have a shortcut. The quest book. This is very important. Shortcut is the Q button. This will show every quest you ever did, and every quest you still need to do, but of course have found. It's lagging a bit. There we go. So yeah, I always think to do the first thing I come in here, and you see this this quest, for example. It will show you the name of the quest, the recommended level, even though this is just, I won't recommend doing this at level 85, at least not solo, because here it will say the number of participants, but you can solo this at my level. And like every step, when you complete it, it gets a green mark, a little green star, and I still need to get these, and my reward will be around 2.5 million XP. This is, looks like a lot if you're still low level, but at my level this is like only 2 million XP. I mean this will take you a few hours, and this XP I can also get from fighting two of these groups of mobs over here. And you have like separate ones of these, like this one. When you press this monitor thing, it will pop up on the left, so you have it standing over here, so you don't have to go in your quest book all the time. These are just different kind of things. I'm not gonna go into that. Finished, of course, and all quests. It's not really important to see the finished quests or all quests. I always leave it on to do, because I don't need to know about the quests I already finished. Cause look at all these quests, man. This is just a whole lot. Why would I want to read all of this? Oh yeah, these quests. You go. Every time you reach a new area, you get 1000 XP, so if you're still low level, you can get some XP out of that. The next thing, by the way, I know this video is long, but by the time you have seen this all, you will be a lot wiser. So don't fret about it unless you are really, really anxious to get in the game. Same for achievements, shortcut is L. I don't know why they would choose the L. There's no L in achievements. You have certain categories. Events is mostly like Halloween or Christmas, or they have this special summer thing, or St. Patrick or Easter. These only have like a few achievements, not very much. Like you can see, I have 6 out of 13. Professions, these are usually related to what you... How do you say that? Your level. So don't. This will automatically unlock like this one. Not this one, but like this one. Become a level 100 farmer. You will automatically get this. You don't need to look at this. And it will give you field master title. Like I said, those titles from before, from your passport. This one. Then it will say field master, and you can click on that, and you will have that as a title. Nations are also not very important. Most of these are. This isn't even. You can't even get this anymore. This achievement hasn't been removed from the game, but it's impossible to get, as far as I know. Ultimate bosses. I'm not gonna go into this because the first time you can even get one of these is level 85, and by the time you reach level 85, you don't have to watch this video. Dungeons. These are always almost the same. They consist of a few things. You always have three or four things when completing dungeon achievements. One is finish the dungeon. It doesn't say, but this needs to be normal, not easy dungeon. If they have easy, kill the boss first, kill the boss last. That's usually all you need to do in order to get it, and you will usually get a boss statue. I have a whole lot of those. I will go into my haven back. Once again, I have a separate video about that. If you have PvP on, it will take some time longer. I don't know why they have that, but you can use those statues to make your haven back look better. This is mine. I gather these things. I think it's fun. So these are all the bosses. No, not all of them, because I don't have every statue yet, but most of the bosses will be here. And so yeah, that's I think it looks cool. Yeah, this is the haven back, by the way. I have a separate video about that. It's your personal space, basically. And yeah, I will leave a link in the description and an annotation at the end of the video. So yeah, that's it for achievements. You also have discovery, which usually kill certain mobs, like this one, kill 5 of every type of Beeblies and 1 aggressive one, and you will get this breastplate, for example. But also other things that are more, you have these are important. These are all treasures. These are all hidden throughout the world. And those artifacts on your passport, you need those to get to access those treasures. Like this one bypasses barriers, and this one allows you to jump over gaps. So you need these kind of things if you want to gain a lot of commas and extra additional XP. So yeah, the dungeons shortcut is D for dungeons. This will show you you can think these if you want. Available only shows the ones that are available for your level, because Witch's Lair is only during Halloween, and it's not available right now, but it's available for your level. And you can see all the dungeons here. It's not really gives not that much info, just the location, level, and the name of the dungeon. Not really worth looking into. Tutorials, these are basically hints. You can click on these and to recap certain things about the game, and they will give you info. It can be helpful if you're still low level and you need to be reminded of something. Haven back, I just showed you. Once again, separate video, leave a link in the description at and also at the end of the video. The map shortcut is M. I'm in Harborg country, or Herborg, I'm not sure how to pronounce that in English, because I'm not English myself, as you might have guessed from my accent. I'm actually from the Netherlands. This will show you transportation points, the clan members, and this green mark means there's a quest or something of importance over here, but I already went here. This is bugged. This should disappear, but it doesn't. I don't want to see any transportation. You can click on here and it will go off. And these, except for this one, this question mark, you will get this as soon as you log in for the first time. But these ones will unlock relating to the professions, like I mentioned before. So when you think, oh, I can mine a lot of good ores here, you can put this here. And you will know that there will be a lot of mineable ores over here. Even though you can mine ores here. Or at least not a lot. And this one is the most nifty one. I need to go over here. It will say compass, and it will show this bar around you. And the closer you get, the tighter those white lines get to the circle, so you know about the distance and which direction you need to go in. It can be really helpful if you're in a crowded place. And you can zoom out and zoom in. This doesn't zoom out for some reason, but maybe this map is bugged. But you can access other regions if you want to. The mini map, this doesn't show if you're just beginning the game. You have to manually access this. The shortcut for this is Shift M. When you press that, it will appear and reappear. For you, it will be in the middle of the screen, but it will appear where you last had it standing, or hovering, or whatever you want to call it. And of course, the menu options. This will show you about game, video, sound, commands. You can manually adjust these, but I don't recommend it. I mean, it's already very good. I've never needed to adjust a single shortcut, unless your keyboard is broken or something. Then recommend going in here, and you can cancel those or apply those if you need to, and of course change character, log out, quit and resume. Then we're almost ready, just a few more things. We had the most basic important things behind, so you can go in the game now. I'm just gonna go a little further about a few tiny things. The first thing of course is your health. It's here in the middle. You can click on it to make it have a different view. I leave it at the HP that I currently have. This will be different if you're not a sacred here. This will show something about your class. Mine shows anger. This thing here is your wakfu / status gouge. When you commit something that's bad for the environment, like cutting a tree, you will gain stasis, but when you like plant a tree, you gain wakfu. And you don't really have to look at this, this doesn't really affect your game. But if you want to go for governor, like I said before, you want to have 99 wakfu. Unless you are a Foggernaut, Foggernauts get more damage if they have this status higher. Or maybe not more damage, but at least they get a buff. I'm not sure what it is. I haven't really looked into that. But if you're Foggernaut, stasis is good. Otherwise, it doesn't really matter unless you run for governor. But believe me, running for governor is very hard. If you are achievement hunter and you want to get have this link to Steam, like I have, you probably won't never ever get the governor achievement. Because there are like 5 people who apply and they all have major guilds behind their back. And it's a pretty hefty task. And here you will see the citizenship points like I already mentioned. And a few more things, these two buttons, this one will change the mode. So you can see your shortcuts for your spells or for the overworld. And this one, shortcut is E also. For the emotes, these will unlock gradually as you progress through the game or hunt for them. I have several emote hunt videos. I will make some more later on. Right now I have about 5, I think, links in the description. The first one are without a microphone, so I'm sorry for that. But that's just how my earlier videos were. And smileys, everyone has these already. And these are adjusted to your character, so the skin color and the hair color will still be the same if you change that. So if you have Sekir with the red hair, it will have red hair instead of blonde. And you can also just type these in, so if I do / D, it will set it in the guild now. I don't know why, yeah, so it will say / D, of a double dot D, not / D. And the last thing is the environment, like I mentioned with the citizenship points. Like here you see mechas, which are these robots. There need to be between 80 and 160 mechas, and there are 150 right now. So if I would plant or kill some right now, it wouldn't affect anything. These little bars means there are restrictions on it, like you also see here. But these don't have restrictions on it, so everybody already harvested every plant, crops and trees over here. And these are the ores, by the way. You can mine these if you have the high level of mining. I don't have 90 yet. I'm at 50, I think 45 maybe. This will also show the clan member, which you also see here. You can talk to him. Most of them don't do anything. The ones in the nations do unlock separate achievements. So I recommend just talking to them in the nations. Just you can exit immediately again, but just so the game knows you talk to them. So yeah, if you want to do something good for the environment or want to cut something down, check this first. Otherwise, you will gain negative points if you're not looking right. And this will say which nation it's allied to, this region. But this region is separate, it's on an island, so it's not allied to anything. Then you have the climate, shortcut is X. I never look at this personally, but I know what it is. It will show you what's the right condition for these certain crops and plants to grow. And it means like this one, cherry tree, it needs to be between 25 and 40 degrees in order for it to grow, but it's minus 5 till 25, so this, or I mean it's minus 20 till minus 5 because it's ice everywhere, so this thing can grow here. And it needs if it's sunny, it will be it will grow faster. And this one, clan member. It's just information about the clan member itself. It's basically a passport for the clan member. So yeah, that was it for this video. I hope you learned a lot and can now go to the World of Thrall and you know where to find everything. Oh yeah, one more thing. Up here you can report a bug or a problem. Only if you have a bug you will need to look at this. But I must say, Wakfu does have some bugs. Some people call it bugfu at some point, because mostly in fights some things can be bugged. Like Xcarnus is bugged, which is an ultimate boss. And some of the higher dungeons have a lot of variables which are accounted for, and that kind of slows down the game. So that's a problem. But yeah, that was it for this video. If you have any questions, don't be afraid to leave them in the comments. And I hope this helped you out and that you are now able to find everything in the World of Thrall that you were looking for. I will make separate videos on and go in depth about the characteristics and the spells and sidekicks later on other videos. I'm not sure yet when. So I see you guys later and thanks for watching. Bye. Oh, 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 oh